The first part of it was really interesting to me. On if he's trying too hard to make the perfect play, and we had this conversation a lot in terms of, you know, the run pass options or all the audibles that he's been doing and them not necessarily like ending up with like big, huge plays. Is he like, oh, this is good, but I can do better, and looking too much for the perfect play versus, hey, this play will do just fine.
Yeah.
No, you know what I'm saying?
This is very Martin Perez. Mike used to talk about Martin Perez. He would get to, you know, two strikes, and then he's trying to make the perfect pitch to get that strikeout. And when maybe for Martin Perez, the best pitch was just go ahead and get the ground ball or get the double play ball, because he was so good at getting the double play ball. Instead of trying to make perfect pitches for the strikeout, just get the play done that moves the chains. That's where I think that Dak's biggest struggle might be. I'm trying to strike big. I'm trying to do something. I want to see something big that I have downfield, but it's not the right one. That's what the way I feel sometimes, that he wants something good, something amazing. This was Romo, right?
Yes.
Like, we had a big problem with Romo about that, was he felt like he had to be a hero on every play.
I always felt like, for Romo, to your point, you're right, but that's the only way he made it in the NFL.
Yes.
So how could you take a dude that was undrafted, nobody really wanted.
That had everything to do with it.
Nobody saw him as a starting quarterback ever. We were taking baseball players left and right because we didn't even think he was really that good, our own organization. And he's like,
we said he was always trying to prove that he belonged.
Right. I'm going to be the riskiest quarterback in football history. And it paid off because he became a starter. He became a multimillionaire. He became a guy that led a team to the playoffs, almost looked like a Super Bowl team. But you couldn't really coach that out of him because he's like, the only way I made it was doing it this way.
Mm-hmm. Do you think when he changed in 14, then it was just a product of having an awesome run game? Or was it seeing how late in his career he was and he was like, maybe this is a better path?
Both.
Okay.
There was, at that point, there was very little to prove, if that makes sense. As in, like, I can't make any more money I'm stable. Does that make sense? I think that it took him for a long time to believe, I'm actually stable in this position. And then once he felt that way, 2 years later, he gets hurt and his job's over because Dak takes it.
You know, to your point of that's the only way he made it in the NFL, Dak Prescott earned his job by not turning the ball over. By being a very conservative quarterback.
That's a great point.
And not taking too many risks. And then whenever he does,
where it was going.
Yeah, then when he does take a few risks, what happens? Everybody crushes him for, hey, what are you doing? Yeah. You know, like, why are you throwing so many interceptions, when he's like, I'm trying to take these risks.
Who is Dak? And this goes back to the core of Dak. Dak does not want to turn the ball over. It does go, and I'm not saying this is everything, because people change, but it goes to mom saying, do not turn the ball over.
And this is what I wonder sometimes, if quarterbacks really do listen, or players in general, really do listen to the outside noise. Because you look at 2016 and to a certain extent 2018, significantly more conservative than he has been at other times. And he did not turn, like, he did a great job taking care of the ball and the team was winning. But when he puts up the gaudier stats, the team has been losing. But is that cause and effect correct? Or is it the cause of an effect of the defense was trash and you kind of had to air it out? Yeah. Like, sometimes the cause and effect a little murky.
I think it's a great question, right? But it's not a yes or no answer, because there's so things that play into that's a very tough yes or no type of question. Is, I look at Dak, and Dak is trying to be better at reading defenses. And it sounds like, from the people who are big experts on this, I'm not. Like, I'll admit when I'm not an expert on quarterbacks and the ability to read defenses. But I am amazed when I do watch Joe Burrow and Patrick Mahomes before the Dallas Cowboy game on how many times they are throwing a person open or throwing to a guy who's covered, and yet it still becomes a completion because they see something there that's not there. And Dak doesn't seem to be at that stage yet of his career. Will he be there? I don't know. Will he never be that guy? Will he always have to see the kind of light, the opening to throw to, and doesn't want to be that guy who throws into coverage and goes, yeah, but I'm throwing it away from this guy and away from this guy, and I'm giving my guy a chance to make a play on this, or I know that he's going to break here. I know that the ball's going to be in his chest right when he turns his head.